Welcome to another presentation about the Carolina Bays. The Carolina Bays are the most prevalent geological structures in the Atlantic coastal plain. Well-preserved bays are elliptical with raised rims, and they are oriented toward the Great Lakes. Nebraska has similar elliptical basins that are also oriented toward the Great Lakes. The origin of the Carolina Bays has been vigorously debated since the bays were first studied in the 1930s. The most prevalent geological explanation is that the bays originated as thermokarst lakes from melting permafrost and that their sandy rims were created by the prevailing winds. Opponents of the thermokarst hypothesis point out that North Carolina and South Carolina, where many Carolina bays are found, never had permafrost even during the last glacial maximum, and that thermokarst lakes seldom have mathematically elliptical geometry. This presentation discusses some cities that have been built on top of the Carolina Bays. A satellite image of Wilmington, North Carolina, shows only the streets of a residential neighborhood. Looking at this image, we would not know that this is the center of a large Carolina Bay. A LiDAR image of the same area reveals several Carolina Bays, the largest of which is Blythe Bay, with a length of 2,880 meters, or about 1.8 miles. The rim of Blythe Bay is approximately 4 meters higher than the center of the bay. There are hundreds of houses within this bay. Many bays have wet interiors, but Blythe Bay is kept dry by a drainage channel on the east side of the bay. A sand sheet that originated from the adjacent Cape Fear River provides a clue about the sequence of formation of these bays. The sand sheet overlays Blythe Bay, which means that Blythe Bay formed before the sand sheet was deposited. However, the rim of the small bay neatly trims the sand sheet. This means that the small bay was created after the sand sheet was deposited. This analysis would not be possible without LiDAR. This is version 2 of this video. I would like to thank Christopher Sweezy for pointing out a couple of errors in the previous version. Hartsville is in South Carolina, not North Carolina, and the area immediately west of Hartsville without Carolina Bays is called the Carolina Sandhills region of the Atlantic coastal plain. This LiDAR image shows the boundary of the Carolina Sandhills and the flat portion of the Atlantic coastal plain. The Piedmont is several miles west of Hartsville. The majority of the Carolina Bays have only been preserved on the flat, sandy terrain. There are Carolina Bays on the Carolina Sandhills, but they are mostly on top of hills that have fairly flat tops. These bays are found about 155 kilometers from the Atlantic Ocean at an elevation of 115 meters above sea level near the city of Cassatt, South Carolina. The bays are fragile sandy structures that become distorted and wash away on inclined terrain. We will now zoom in on Hartsville, South Carolina. The LiDAR image shows a multitude of Carolina bays, but we can see a faint network of streets and roads. The satellite image of the same area shows all the man-made structures, but it is impossible to see any Carolina Bays. Going back to the LiDAR image, we can see an interesting feature that looks like a cross on a hill. This is a closer view of the cross on the hill. The satellite view of the same area shows that the cross is made of four adjacent baseball fields. This is a ground view of one of the baseball fields. Notice that the infield is slightly elevated, and this is why it appears as a hill on the LiDAR image. The LiDAR images have 20 times vertical exaggeration to bring out details that can be overlooked at surface level. There is a road that crosses the rim of the bay next to the baseball park. Using the street view of Google Maps, we can see the almost imperceptible raised rim of the bay. This is why the Carolina Bays did not get attention until after the invention of the airplane and aerial photography in the 1930s. From one level, there is nothing to see. We are going to examine in greater detail two overlapping Carolina Bays that are approximately 67 to 69 meters above sea level. We can see that several roads crisscross the bays, but it is evident that a small bay is overlaying a larger bay. I selected some points along the perimeter of the larger bay, and I fit an ellipse to the points using the least squares method. There's a link to this program in the description of the video. I avoided selecting any points where the bays overlap because at this point the rim of the large bay has been overlaid by the small bay. The fit is very good. All the points of the bay perimeter follow the elliptical path. The large bay has a major axis of 465 meters and a minor axis of 299 meters. The small bay also has a good fit. All the points along the perimeter fall on the elliptical path. The small bay has a major axis of 316 meters and a minor axis of 224 meters. In 1933, Professors Melton and Shriver from the University of Oklahoma described one attribute of the Carolina Bays as mutual interference of outline. Their paper was titled, "The Carolina Bays, Are They Meteorite Scars?" They wrote this about intersecting bays. Quote, "The mutual intersection of some of the bays implies that their origins were not simultaneous. Where the interference is of such a nature that one is somewhat obscured by another, the bay preserving its entire elliptical outline may be of either large or small size. Examples of both relationships may be seen." End quote. Mainstream geologists consider the Carolina Bays to have originated as thermokarst lakes, but this hypothesis has many deficiencies. Carolina Bays have raised rims, mathematically elliptical shape, and they are oriented toward the Great Lakes. Thermokarst lakes form as sinkholes that fill with water when permafrost melts. Thermokarst lakes have irregular shapes and they don't have raised rims. The Atlantic coastal plain in North Carolina and South Carolina never had permafrost even during the last glacial maximum, so something is very wrong with the official version about the origin of the Carolina Bays. Thank you for joining me in the investigation of the Carolina Bays and the Younger Dryas Cataclysm. There's a link to the LiDAR visualization tool in the description of the video. My book about the Carolina Bays is available at Amazon. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel to be notified of future videos about the Carolina Bays and other scientific topics.